In this proof-of-concept video, a sniffing attack against a low pin count bus communication of a trusted platform module is demonstrated. This attack can be used to gain knowledge of cryptographic keys used by the Microsoft BitLocker full disk encryption in specific configurations. In January 2019, Hector Martin mentioned this kind of sniffing attack on Twitter, and a few weeks later Denis Anjankovic described his approach in reproducing this LPC bus sniffing attack in his blog article Extracting BitLocker Keys from a TPM. Based on publicly available tools, we have created our own open source implementation named iStick LPC TPM Sniffer for performing LPC bus sniffing attacks in order to extract cryptographic BitLocker keys from a TPM. You can download our iStick LPC TPM Sniffer from GitHub. Here you can see the targeted trusted platform module, an ASUS TPM-M R2.0 using an Infineon SLB 9665 chip on the right and a Lattice iStick evaluation kit on the left, which is used as sniffing device. In this proof of concept video, a current Windows 10 computer system using BitLocker in TPM only mode is attacked. For sniffing the LPC bus communication, an attacker needs physical access to 8 pins of the TPM. This close-up view shows the TPM on the mainboard of the target computer system. Here you can see the used test setup with the target computer system, its trusted platform module, its BitLocker encrypted drive, the attacker computer system, and the Lattice iStick already connected to the TPM. First, the attacker connects the iStick to his computer. Then he builds the iStick LPC TPM sniffer using the open source FPGA toolchain SymbiFlow and its respective components for the ICE40 FPGA. The bitstream of small designs like this one can be built and written to the FPGA very quickly. A simple Python tool named ICE LPC TPM Sniffer is used for talking to the FPGA-based sniffer via fast serial communication. Now, the attacker turns on the target computer system, sniffs the LPC bus communication, and immediately shuts down the target system after the current BitLocker volume master key was successfully received. Next, he attaches the BitLocker encrypted drive of the target computer system to his attacker system. Using the software tool DisLocker Metadata, he extracts metadata of the encrypted BitLocker partition he is interested in and saves it to a file. With the sniffed BitLocker volume master key, it is now possible to successfully decrypt the encrypted BitLocker full volume encryption key contained within the extracted metadata. Now the BitLocker encrypted partition can be mounted on the attacker system using the software tool DisLocker. In order to get both read and write access to the NTFS partition, it is usually required to fix the file system first to have a clean state. Finally, the decrypted content of the NTFS partition can be accessed and also modified at will. Therefore, we do not recommend using BitLocker in TPM-only mode, but with a pre-boot authentication requiring one or more other authentication factors.